What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about boundary layer displacement thicknesses. So there are a few different ways to characterize what a boundary layer is, and if you don't know what a boundary layer is or how to do it, how to calculate it the main way, check out this video here. But let's say we've looked at this video and we know what that is. We want to look at some other ways. One way is called the displacement thickness. So we're going to be covering what is it and how to calculate it. So let's say we have a regular flat plate and we have a flow going over it, and we know that a boundary layer will form. So we'll have the velocity profile that looks like this. Now we know that we can calculate the height of the boundary layer based on the point at which the velocity here is 99% of the free stream velocity. And we can denote that as delta 99. But there's another aspect which is called the displacement thickness. So let's say we look at each point along this boundary layer profile, this point for example, and we see that the velocity is 50% of the free stream velocity. And then we go up and it's 80%, and go up it's 90, and we finally get to 99%. So the question is, how much has this effectively displaced the fluid? So in other words, if we had another surface and we said we have a free stream velocity and there is now a secondary surface here, an imaginary surface, how far would this surface be from this surface, and we still have the exact same free stream flow here without a boundary layer? So in other words, it's implicit this is a slip condition kind of thing. Well, in order to figure out what that distance is, we can use a equation which is written like this. The displacement thickness equals the integral, approximately, the integral from 0 to the height of the boundary layer of 1 minus u divided by the free stream velocity times delta u. And this is delta y, sorry. This is y going this direction. So this is important because it tells us effectively how much the fluid has had to move up overall. It also can be used for something called a shape factor, which we'll get into in the next couple of weeks once we've covered a couple other concepts. And what the shape factor does is it can tell us whether a boundary layer is turbulent or laminar. And for this displacement thickness, we can use this equation, or we can simplify it in under certain circumstances. So let's say we have a flat plate and it's a Blasius boundary layer, which we'll cover in the coming weeks. So we can calculate this as, or simplify it effectively, as 1.72 nu x on a square root here on nu infinity. And this is the thickness as we go along in the x direction. So we know what nu is, the viscosity, the free stream velocity here, and 1.72. And generally speaking, this is going to equal approximately a delta 99 on 3. Now this is just an approximate value. So if we were to calculate the height of this boundary layer and divide it by 3, that's about how much this is. It actually changes whether the boundary layer is turbulent or laminar, and also the progression of it. But this is a general approximation. The far more accurate approximation is this equation here. So this is how you calculate the boundary layer displacement thickness and understand how the boundary layer has affected the flow having to move up. And in the next coming weeks, we'll look at the shape factor as well as the momentum thickness. So that is it in this video. If you liked it, make sure to like it and click the subscribe button. And I'll see you soon. Peace, amigos.